Sean Cheek, and welcome to my Easy Piano Lessons. You can contact me by sending me an email to easypianolessons@yahoo.com, or you can check out the website www.webpianoteacher.com. I have about 750 videos on there that aren't on YouTube, so if you're wondering where some of those second, third parts are, they're on the website there. We're doing the intro here to John Lennon's Grow Old With Me. And we're going to start with right hand here, below middle C. So here's middle C. We're going to do a D way down here. Okay, we're going to do that with the thumb, all right? So first we have a D all by itself. And then we're going to have a G and a B together after that. So we start with just that pickup note. We're going to go back down to the D. And then back up to the G and the B. Then back down to the D with the thumb. Okay, and then back to the G and the B. See how all of this is just the same three notes? Remember, this is a pickup note, so this is the pickup to the downbeat here. Then we're going to have a single A, and then a single B, and then back down to a low D here. Okay, and it's all the same rhythm, just straight eighth notes. The left hand, we're going to have a G right here. All right, here's middle C, here's the next C. This is the G we want. All right, we're going to play that right here. Together, you play the D, and then you play this together. And together here. All right, here we're going to have middle C and D together. And then we're going to go down back to that low D on the thumb. And then back to the high D. And back down to the low D. The left hand is going to have something, and then we'll have AD at the end. AD. So, bum, 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 left, left. Okay? The left hand is going to have a low D here. Alright, low D way down here. And then we're going to have that D again right here. And then the higher D that the right hand was playing, we're going to play it with the left hand. Alright? And if you're wondering why I'm playing the left hand D there and the right hand the same D, it's just so it'll sound right. So make sure you do that with the left hand and then do this D with the right hand. So we play hands together here. And then right, right, right. And then left, left. But you can get that right hand out of the way so the left hand can play. And then right, right. So we have bum, 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 bum. Okay? So from the beginning, the first two boxes will have bum, bum. Here we have C and D together again, and then back down to the lower D, back up to the C and the D, back down to the lower D. So bum 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 right here, and left hand will have a low D, and then the higher D here that the thumb was on the right hand. Now I didn't put a D right here because I don't hear one in the recording, and I don't put it in there if I don't hear it. But it's hard for me not to play a D there, a low D. So maybe if you want to put a low D in there, okay? That will feel better to you. Just put a low D in there, in that one space there. Okay, but I don't hear it in the recording, so you know, leave it out if you want to do it just like the recording. So this box here at the end, we have bum 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 left left, and the measure isn't finished. We're going to finish it up here, and we're going to have C and D again together. And then the D on the thumb, and then back to G and B here like we started with at the beginning, down to a lower D, B and G, back to the lower D. I have a little dash there because we're going to hold that note out a little bit, bum, bum, grow, and then we start the singing right here. Grow. All right, so D, and then the G and the B again, but make sure you hold this D. Ba, ba. And when you play that, that's when you sing grow. And of course, left hand's on a G there. Play that together with that. So let's do it. Let me start here with this box, and then we'll do this box. So we'll start here and finish out in red. So one, two. Finish it on the website. But anyway, there is part one, and make sure when you're using the pedal that you you change it, you know, whenever, pretty much each box, whenever the chord changes, so you don't want to blur everything. So I hope y'all enjoy that, and again, you can contact me at easypianolessons@yahoo.com if you have any questions or any comments. Hope you enjoy it.